For every million a saver had at the National Social Security Fund at the end of June, they will earn an interest of 100,000 shillings. This follows the declaration of a 10% interest on member savings by the Finance Minister Matia Kasaija at the NSSF 11th Annual Members Meeting held in Kampala today.
This is a very commendable, given the turmoil in Europe, to do the things you know has been taking place in Europe. Investor flight from most of the developing markets back to the USA, reduction in value across all East African stock markets, and the increased scrutiny that the fund underwent in the third quarter of the just concluded financial year.
The declaration followed an announcement of the fund's performance last week that saw the entity post total realized income of 2.2 trillion shillings amidst a challenging year characterized by poorly performing stocks in regional markets and appreciation of the local currency, eroding the value of the fund's investments abroad.
The savers are known workers. There are people who were not known workers. Many people are working in the rural areas. They are farmers, they are traders. They are not registered at all. So when you look at the population and the amount that is saved, the issue is the would be savers are not registered, and the law, unless we amend it, does not take in anybody who has not been registered through through earning a salary or a wage.
Social security is not a drag of economic development, but a powerful force driving it forward. By prioritizing social security, we are demonstrating that growth and development do not benefit from denying people a fair share of productivity gains our societies are generating, nor are economic transformation and innovation served by leaving the poor behind.
Now, the focus has been turned on full implementation of the new NSSF Act to increase compliance and widen the social security net to cover voluntary savers.
The average measure for efficiency, and that's the thing, for this app, we should be spending 2.1% of our assets on expenses. And that means, instead of spending 1.09, you should be spending close to 300 million shillings. We only spend 1.02%, and we're driving that number to below 1%. Now, the only thing that happened here, our total income, whatever I showed you, evaluation, I showed the realized income, our total income was impacted by what we talked about in Kenya when we did the valuation, about 1.04 trillion shillings in terms caused by the depreciation of the Kenya shilling.
The fund is targeting to hit the 20 trillion mark in asset value by June next year from the current 18.6 trillion recorded at the end of June 2023. Story by Benjamin Jambo for the news.